Alright, say hello to the newest iteration of Reverend Claytown. I got like a cool, like, Mad Max kind of leather biker thing going on. Not biker, but like a... You know what I'm saying. I kind of look like a medieval Mad Max. I dig it. With a monocle. Because I'm classy. Alright, back to it. Let's go. I'll see ya. So that's what my magic bullshit looks like.
Hear ye, hear ye! The Duke's break!
Whoop! Butterfingers! They'll decrease your affinity. Yeah!
State your business. Pawn guild.
That guy's got little eyes. I don't trust him.
Through here and to the left.
Beady eyes.
Just don't make a nuisance of
yourself. Your eyes are too small for your face. You look like a potato with two peas just like glued to the front of it.
Seems this is where the merchants live.
The pawn guild stands ahead. It is a gathering place for my kind. If we want information, we'll have to ask around.
Oh. That's, something tragic going on here, isn't it?
Please. Please, sir. Sir, I know it is not a matter fit to thrust upon a passing stranger, but... Please. I ask only that you listen a while. Just a short while. Thank you, sir. This child is... Is my son. Was my son. His heart stopped.
Oh, that sucks, buddy.
Not a few hours past. Always weak, his sweet heart. Since he was but a babe. I had long known he would not live long.
Yeah.
But to see it, to watch him slip from my grasp, I am left with naught but rage at my impotence.
Yep, I can imagine.
Try
don't
any means
see what that has to do
back.
With me, though.
I look to magic. Even curses.
Even curses?
Anything
you want
to
curse
bring
him?
Him back to me.
You want to turn him into a Zimbambo?
Madness,
that's wrong.
But still, I...
Don't do that.
Here. Pray. Accept these...
Sudden musical sting. Okay.
The first of those stones I bought from a merchant my son and I passed in our travels. He spoke of a powerful magic within it. Gather rocks such as this together, he said, and even the dead shall wake. Not that I am one to blindly believe in such tales, mind. Yet still... I thought there no harm in trying, and so I searched. But by the time I found a second, the whole pursuit rang hollow. 'Tis a vain hope to seek immortality in such trinkets, I know. I felt a fool for having e'er believed it.
Wake stones are miraculous items that can bring your character, pawn allies, or others back to life. Treasure each wake stone, for the fragments required to form them are quite rare, and each stone can only be used once. Gather enough wakestone shards and they will automatically assemble it to form a complete stone. Alright, kids, look up.
Smithy, I should think.
That's it. Thank you, Jiraku. Yeah, the wakestone is our fairy in a bottle. Should I die, it'll basically pop up and say, hey, you want to use a wakestone? I can select yes or no. If I select yes, the wakestone activates, I come back to life with like half health, and I lose it. So yeah.
So this is
triple
the
question marks.
Gear.
I like your helmet, Boo. Sup, loser?
Welcome, Arisen.
You look like...
We have awaited your coming.
You look like Jesse Eisenberg, and I don't like you for that reason.
This pawn is called Barnaby. I tend to the affairs of the Pawn Guild. The guild serves as a place of rest for pawns, and as the gate to the Everfall. The Everfall lies beneath Grand Sorin. It is a place of great importance to our kind.
I can't wait to go tromping through it.
But for now... Let us rejoice in the coming of the Arisen, the light that guides the Legion.
I feel more familiar with this quest now.
Well, it would be interesting if you're just like talking to a guy, right? Like you're just having a conversation. You're like, oh, hey, thanks, man. Like he had asked him previously, like, hey, can you go down to the break room and like get me some paper clips? And he's like, all right. And then he like comes back. It's like, oh, hey, here's your paper clips. It's like, oh, thanks, man. Thanks a lot, man. I appreciate it. Yeah. Like, cool, you saved my bacon. All of a sudden he just went like, oh, and he like burst into like light. Like light flew out of his skin.
It
and like a chorus of angels
you, weary from
started.
As you must be.
And it's just like, but I oh, okay. I don't know what just happened. He's like, oh, I just leveled up. It's like, oh.
I would beg your assistance in this matter, Arisen, if it please you.
All right.
You have my thanks.
I know you do. All right, chums.
Beyond lies the Everfall, an ancient place that sleeps beneath Grand Sorin's stones. We pawns have long served as keepers of the entrance to this place. But since the dragon's coming, a strange aura has filled the Everfall. A presence.
Yes.
If it be some omen of evil to come, we cannot allow it to go unchecked. I ask that you seek out the cause of the change, or some proof of what's happened. The Everfall is a place unique unto itself. This is not a simple task, nor a favor I ask lightly, which is why I ask you, Arisen. Please, lend us your aid.
Alright, let's get to it, boys. And girls. The Everfall. Ah, remember? Can't wait to go tromping through it. I'm just gonna desecrate the shit out of this temple. Or this quote-unquote sacred place. That's a fuck ton of bats. Yeah, so you might notice, when you have the magic bow, I get this fancy circle. That's because, as long as I put something in that circle and you see that other circle come up, boom, my arrow's home. Don't think that the reason I ultimately went with Magic Archer is because I have homing arrows now, and thus it, like, nullifies how shitty my aim is. Because that's just a, coincidence. Purely. Purely a coincidence. In fact, I'm a little offended you even implied anything else.
I'll take that.
Ah, fucking bats. So that's the skill I just got, by the way.
We may be within Grand Sorin's gates, but this place holds monsters just the same.
Yeah, any time is right. It's about time. Zimbambos! So, you notice that, it'll become more apparent later. Yeah, I'm not doing very much damage. Yeah. So whenever I, why did you use ice? Zombies are weak, sick of fire. Why did you give me ice, Dash? You dumb bastard. But anyway, yeah. So whenever I, use that, my bolt turns blue. The reason that my bolt turns blue is because it's ice charged. Each magic archer ability is charged with a certain element. So like the exploding bolt is fire. The one that goes up and then rains down is light, I think. And the one that bounces off walls, I think, is electricity or darkness, one of the two. And yeah, so each one is attuned to a certain element. So, the downside to the Magic Archer, at least one of them, is that if I'm fighting something that is, like, is resistant to fire or ice or whatever my chosen skill is, whatever my chosen, shot is, I do less damage because it's attuned to that. So, yeah. That's the downside to being a Magic Archer. Upside is, if you have like, if a mage, like, a, you know, gives me fire damage.
Warrior of bone!
Anyways, also I think Skellingtons are pretty resistant. Ow. pretty resistant to magic. So, yeah, this is a bad... Ow! First mission to, using it, so... But whatever. Anyway, yeah. Yeah, so the upside is if you're fighting something that is weak against certain elements, and like if he's weak to fire and lightning, like harpies are, then I can have my mage charge me with lightning and then use the exploding bolt, which is fire charge, and do double element weakness damage. So that's an upside. It's all upsides and downsides. Magic archers. It's fun. It's fun because there's a lot of, you can almost say, like, it's, like, a lot of, give and take, you know?
Strength in numbers, Arisen.
Alright, let's get back to this. Let's do this!
This place hides something.
So yeah, that opens up the gates. So now we got a straight shot. I missed. Okay, the downside to Sunburst. It's easy to miss. Simbambos might be weak to cold too, I'm not sure. I know they're weak to fire and light for some reason. Which, once again, light and dark are elements in this game. Yeah, just threw that Zimbambo off the edge. Which actually is a valid strategy in this game. Ah! Ah! Okay, you can't just, like, grab them. You have to throw them. He was already dead, but I just wanted to do it. No particular reason. That's also the best part about being a magic archer, just watching your bolts go nuts when you've already killed something. Jiraku running way ahead. Also, there's an ogre here. I completely forgot that. That's not good. Also, if you saw that, the sight of women excites it. Ogres, really terrifying. Especially early on. Forgot there was one down here. Yeah, ogres love the ladies. Oh! Oh, I thought it was gonna, like, jump all the way over here. Oh, he's charging! He's charging. He's not happy. He's not having it. Okay, time to go. Time to bounce. See how much damage we're doing to it? The answer is nothing. But we're gonna kill it. Because Reverend Claytown don't give up. I'm genuinely considering saving right now, though. I might just do that. I can't. We're in the middle of combat. Never mind. Damn it. Oh, Kali, no! Way to go, Jiraku. Way to go. Way to go, buddy. Yeah, their raw power makes them a threat, as does everything else they do. God, maybe we shouldn't be doing this. So yeah, I have killed this thing before. I feel like, if I remember correctly, most of the time I just run away, though. Oh! For the obvious reasons, as you may gather. Most of the time I run away. I have killed it before. The go-to way is if you can manage to get it to jump off a cliff just like that! Oh yeah, that's how we do it, son! That is exactly how we do it. Yep, you gotta think smart. Fight smarter, not harder. Thank you, Dash. An empty flask. Okay.
What's this?
Kinda done with these bats, though, I gotta say.
How deep this place? Just how far does it go?
Thank you. So here's the thing. You see that locked gate back there, like right next to the ogre? If I go back, I can open that, and I think there's treasure back there, so I'm actually gonna go do that. What the hell is that? What is that noise? Alright, whatever. We're gonna go open that shit. See, rooms like this, areas like this, is when the, wow. Is when the ability to, the wall bounce arrows get really, really good is in areas like this. Like, hallways, tight hallways and little rooms, like, it would basically just destroy everything in this room. Almost instantly. Scatter those bones! I might go back to Tusk and Toss, Toss and Trigger, because Sunburst, while really cool, tends to miss, as I'm remembering. Because I was wondering, it's like, was there ever a reason why I never used Sunburst? Yeah, that's it. That's why. Wait, what? Torn Grimoire Appendix. You know, just average day killings and bambos. Tusk and Trigger, you can at least, like, target a bit better. You got a silver ring? Hey, Jiraku, how's about you don't fucking take my shit from me? Useful only as personal adornment. Yeah. I'll still give it to Kali. It gives a little bit of defense.
If you feel a foe is beyond our means, there is no shame in fear.
Ain't that the truth? Alright, remember kids, kinda like me and the bandits. If you're ever, like, getting your ass whipped over and over again, fucking just run away. Ain't no shame. I guess I was wrong. I guess there's no treasure. I could have sworn there's a treasure room somewhere around here. Maybe it's over here. Yeah, there's a treasure chest. Ah! Ah! Jiraku, help me! Yeah, it's weak to fire. I don't know why you keep giving me cold, though, Dash.
Leave your weapons in them. Combat needn't be grueling, Arisen. If the party needs adjusting, adjust it.
I like how, like, the pawn base just straight up says, this game isn't supposed to be impossible, so if you come across an impossible task, change your party. Or start, like, go grind a bit or something. Way to go, Dash. Finally useful. Yeah! After everyone's dead. Way to go, Dash. You are my hero.
What is that?
Ah! Ah! Fuck. Heart piece. Ah! Shit. I fell asleep! Help! Kali, just jumping down there. Little regard for her safety or the safety of others. But, hey, that's how you become a great A-Pon, folks. You say, fuck it, I don't care. I'll jump in that hole with a bunch of skeletons. I ain't afraid. Money, money! Dragon spit. There goes my hero. Watch him as he goes. Alright. Ogre Strategy, Volume 1. The strategy is don't fight ogres. Climbing an ogre when its guard is open and pulling it to the ground. Your pawns have gained knowledge. Yep.
I've gained some new insight.
I've learned a new way to fight, Ariel. I shall restore your health. Hold on.
Interpretive. Petrifying arrow. Oh, good.
What's this?
Ooh, panacea. Or is it, like, panacea?
We'll go no further till we find the switch what opens this door.
Oh, the switch what opens this door, he does! Thank you, Dash. You and your bizarrely British grammar, you're a fucking key to us all. Alright, I don't think we can open that yet. I think we do have to come back for that. So, we'll continue. Alright, now we go back and hit that switch again. Thank you. There should be another switch around here, I think. Oh. Fucked it.
We've only just begun, Master.
Thanks for giving me the pep talk, Jiraku. Yeah, you got it. You got it, boss. Just one more rep. One more rep and we'll do it. That's how exercising works, right? Just do another rep and then magic? Question mark? It's all about reps. Okay, the zombies are getting real chatty. They just keep going on and on about how hungry they are. I don't appreciate that. I'll be honest with you. Is there anything good in there? No? Alright.
Looks as though what doors were closed and open. And those ones
this place hides something.
Shall we take a look?
An undead warrior! There, Mother!
That
was effective! Tis a troubling
get up!
We to fire! Did it!
Yay! Heals for everybody.
What's that?
Where? Oh, they're behind us! That would be a dangerous ambush if they moved at any sort of speed. That would be considered quick. Right? His corpse, like, pushed me back. Did it. We do it. Where's Mbambos? Yeah, I'm pretty sure in classic, like, Dungeons and Dragons, Diablo, like, tradition, zombies, I think, take more damage against blunt attacks rather than, like, cutting attacks, which is obviously what I'm using. So yeah, that's why they take a ton of damage if I don't have fire. Rather, they take a ton of damage to kill.
If they hate fire, they'll load this.
Because I'm gonna give them what they hate. Dash is a real witty guy. He's always on the ball. So first, we're going to explore a bit. Ceremonial cage. Nothing. Dragon spit. I always love in video games whenever, like, you open caskets and, like, items fall out. Like, and not just, like, because, like, I'll buy that you open one of these sarcophagi and, like, a sword is inside. Because, you know, somebody, it's not uncommon for somebody to be buried with their like, ancestral weapons or their magic weapons. That's not great. Like, walking bones, as though we haven't just been fighting, like, a bunch of these guys. But anyways, yeah, like, people being buried with their, like, ancestral weapons, not that weird. An engraved letter. Yeah, not that weird.
What's that?
Lever is firmly attached. First, we're gonna search. But yeah, weapons, armor, whatever, normal. But whenever you open them and, like, food falls out. Like, fresh food, or a potion, or, you know, something like that falls out. I always love it, because it's like, who's putting that in there? Like, who put, like, a potion of healing in the dead guy's coffin? Because that's kind of an insulting, you know? Ooh, a bleout.
Treasure, perhaps?
Am I alone in wishing to be out of this place?
No, not really. Scale coat. Let's see if that's worth anything to me. Not particularly, but I bet Kali wants it. Oh, she can't even wear that. But she can wear the scale coat. There we go. Wah. Like a cool guy. Yeah, I know a lot of people, and myself included, like, the first time I played this game. Oh, hey, look. So, we just looped around. But a lot of people, when they first play the game, myself included, you get to the bottom of this, well, and, yeah, immediately run over and just, like, grab that glowing thing over there. Because it's in the middle of the room! It's a big glowing thing! Why wouldn't you grab it? And you'll see what happens when we grab it. But a lot of people miss out on that good shit, because they grab the glowing thing and then never really come back and explore it. Once again, you'll see why in a bit. Hand covers, I already have those. Speaking of, do you have any? Do you have any gloves on, Kali? No, you do not. Alright, sorry about that, boo. You're going without hands. Why'd you tell me? You're gonna have cold fingers. And a Wakestone shard! So now we have a Wakestone, a full Wakestone. Liquid Vim. Because if you recall, that one dude crying about his dead son was like, here's some shards I bought, and so he gave us two shards. Poor crystals work in tandem with fairy stones. Embed this poor crystal in the ground in any place save a dungeon. You can use a fairy stone to return there in an instant. So yeah. This game does have fast travel. I feel like one of the things that I hear a lot, or rather heard a lot, whenever I would like be like, play fucking Dragon's Dogma, and I would pimp it out to everybody, and somebody's like, it takes forever to go anywhere, there's no fast travel. No, there is fast travel. You just have to fucking work for it, Nancy. Floor gives off a curious light, and a draft. What's more, something lies below. What? Report back to Barnaby. Yeah, so Jiraku just spoiled the surprise. But yeah, the tentacles, you can kill as many as you want. They will just keep coming back. So we are going to skedaddle. Right, we'll grab Dash, and then we're going to go skedaddle. Come on, Dash. Let's go. Oh, Jiraku, you too. Alright, come on everybody, let's go. We're going! Keep going! Well, I guess you guys are dying. I mean, it's not my fault this time. Like, yeah, I'm running away again, but like... Last time... Admittedly, yeah, last time I told you guys to go fight the bandits and then I ran away. That was my fault. It was my bad. This time, though, I'm telling you to come on, and you're just not going. So, not my fault. I ain't getting blamed for this. Come on, quit trying to fight the tentacles that keep coming back forever. Because it's kind of a losing fight. Well, Jiraku's dead. But, you know what? That's his fault. It's his fault, not mine. It's not my fault. Oh, shit. I was too busy yelling at Jiraku and not running. Or rather, paying attention to my stamina. Alright, we gotta win. Me and Kali, we're out of here! You other losers can just deal. Bye, Jiraku. Bye, Dash. Behave yourself in the Duke's Dominion. Or visit the dungeon. Oh, good. Where might we find Solomon's Grimoire? Ancient scroll. Small coin pouch. Huh. Somebody left their library money here. Sup, buddy?
A light. In the furthest depths, you say. I see. In truth, even we pawns know precious little of the Everfall. I can say with utmost certainty, though, the light you speak of is newly come.
Is it?
We cannot know if this small aberration will give rise to great calamity hence.
I feel like most small aberrations eventually become but great calamities.
Enough is called to take
it's
action.
Just... I've watched a lot of movies. Here
and keep vigilant for further signs of change.
Yep. Way to go. Everybody, high fives. High fives, everybody. We all did it. We do it. We're all heroes.
A stone to recall the dead to living. Stone's red is strange you should mention it. It may come to...
Yeah, okay. Yep. We're all heroes, everybody. Now I'm going to send you back where you came from. Because, well, I've outgrown you. I'm sorry.